What's up, YouTube? Big Bobby Builds here, and today I want to dive into my thoughts on Season 11. We're going to talk about the patch notes, how I think these changes have affected the game, and just general ideas and thoughts and what I think of Season 11 in Apex. So to get us started here, there was a lot of different changes that happened this season. The first one being that we got a new map and we got a new playable legend named Ash. To start, I think the map is incredible. The features are very eye-pleasing. I really like the colors. It's very vivid. It's a bright map, you know, something that we haven't seen before in Apex. All the POIs on the map feel great. They feel unique. There hasn't been one that I've dropped that I just absolutely hate and don't want to go back there. I've said that in the beginning, you know, my first day dropping in, but really, I don't mind dropping anywhere. I do like all the POIs. So good job, Respawn. I think you did a great job on this map, and I'm super excited to keep playing it this season. I really like it for this competitive split and think it's a lot more fun than King's Canyon. As for Ash as a legend, I think she was a fair add to the game. And what I mean by that is I don't think she's super broken, and I don't think that she needs a nerf at this point in time. I think she's balanced and she fits right in and right at home in Apex Legends. If you don't know who I'm talking about and you haven't gotten a chance to play in the new season yet, I'm gonna show you her abilities right here. I will say, if you don't know what these are, I'm not gonna dive too deep into them, but her passive is very good. She can look at the map and see death boxes, and she can also mark those death boxes to find out where enemies are. Her tactical is pretty much an arc star. It goes really far and it snares the first person that it comes in contact with. Her ultimate is basically a wraith portal. It shoots out pretty far, but it is one way. You can only go one way with this. But overall, I really enjoy Ash and I think she's a great fit in Apex Legends. Good job, Respawn. Okay, so moving on, we're gonna talk about Watson. Now, Watson got reworked this season. I myself do not play Watson. I heard she's good. Okay. All right. Watson mains. Don't get mad at me. Being that I don't play Watson, I can't really speak on Watson here, but I can tell you I've had a Watson on my team and that ultimate now puts out so much shield. I think she is viable. I think she is going to be a meta hero. I really enjoyed having her on my team. Maybe I'll learn to play her. Okay. Watson mains. I got you. The supply drops got to change this season. They removed the triple take, put it back on floor loot. I really like this. I think this is fantastic. I have enjoyed using the triple take. I'm a fan of the triple take. It slaps. It's just good. So I'm happy with this change. They put the G7 scout into the supply drop. I have not had it yet. I haven't found it once. Had an alternator, a spitfire, and a craver, but have not seen the scout yet. I'm assuming it's pretty busting because the scout before at 34 damage a shot was great. This is 36 with double tap. I'm not sure what that does, but I'm sure it's busting. Just wait until I can find one. If you were a fan of the triple take before, it's back. Better than ever, baby. Let's go. Next up, let's talk about the car SMG. Not the cars, the car SMG. I really enjoy the gun. I think it's fantastic being able to switch between a light mag and a heavy mag. If your teammate needs one or the other and you find the other, if that makes sense. You know, it's very, very versatile. It does a lot of damage. It's kind of like a R99. You know, obviously it's not putting out as much as fast, but it's still very good. And I am overall happy with this gun. And I get excited when I find this gun. And you know, it's great if you've got a ton of one ammo and your teammate needs the other ammo. It's just, you know, it's awesome, man. So great job on this, Respawn. Also, they changed the gold fully kitted rotation this time, and the car is gold. Now, I've only had that one time, and I died, okay? We don't talk about it. I was so excited. But the fully kitted rotation changed this time. We've got the car, the Mastiff, the 30-30 repeater, the longbow, and the R301. Those are your fully kitted rotation, and you know, I think it's awesome. I'm assuming they do this every season. So, you know, I'm hyped. Nothing for you to be hyped about maybe, but I have had the gold longbow. It was slapping. Obviously the damage isn't changing on these from being gold, but you know, getting these fully kitted guns just ready to go is great. So good, you know, good selection. I like them. I'm happy with their choices. Now, let's get into the nerfs. I truly believe the L-Star needed a nerf. Now, you might be thinking, if you haven't played, the L-Star's nerfed, it's no good anymore. This gun, still broken, okay? Still broken, still just as viable. Think they need to hit it just one more time. Slap her on the butt, drop her down real quick, because it's still just as good. But they did nerf the L-Star. If you don't know what happened, they reduced the projectile size. In Season 10, L-Star bullets look like this. Massive balls, super easy to hit your target, right? This season, you know, they're a bit smaller, you know, maybe like that. But that doesn't stop them from hitting your target. The L-Star is still broken. They also reduced the damage from 18 to 17 a shot. But like I said, you're still beaming. It's still shooting just as fast. The L-Star is still 100% viable here. But they did nerf it a little bit. I'm just waiting on the next one. They also nerfed the Eva. Last season, we saw everybody running the Eva because the Eva, you know, it's just, I mean, it slaps. You know, I use slaps as an example. And what I mean by this is it's just busting, baby. It's just bop, 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 bopping everybody. But they reduced the fire rate from a 2.1 to a 2, which I overall haven't really felt too much of a difference. With a purple shotgun bolt, you're still popping off with the Eva. So, you know, maybe this change, it was needed. You know, everybody prioritized the Eva over any other shotgun. But it's still good, still viable. You still carry it. And the last nerf, I guess, was the longbow. They pumped it up to 60 damage in Season 10. In Season 9, it did 55. They said it was an unnecessary buff. I thought about it and I was like, why would they put it up to 60 in the first place if it was 55? And I realized why they dropped it back down. If you're shooting at someone in white armor, no matter what, at 55 or 60, three shots is going to eliminate this person. If you're shooting at someone in blue armor, three shots at 60 damage will eliminate this person. Three shots at 55 will not. So I understand the change now. I think it was because between white and blue armor, you know, the white doesn't matter, but the blue, you would be killing a person in three shots instead of four shots. So I don't know necessarily if it ever needed that buff like they said. I understand why they've dialed it back, and I think it's fine. I think 100% this is a good map to be sniping on. So I'm okay with this change. Now that we've talked about the nerfs, let's talk about the buff. The buff of the Peacekeeper. This is the buff we've all been waiting on, even though I haven't been here, but it's here. We needed this. The PK is back. Slapping. Doing big damage. They increased the pellet size, which is great. Because now I'm hitting things, and not for nine. The choke-up time was slightly reduced. I mean, this all around, this, you know, of the Peacekeeper. I mean, look at the name. It's a bad boy. I think that's a great change. It kind of put it on the level of the Eva, right? So now it's even with the other shotguns, and I'm okay with it. It's a Peacekeeper. Next up, let's talk about the Hot Zone Gold Rates. In previous seasons, landing at that beautiful blue circle labeled the Hot Zone used to not reward you with the loot as described, okay? This is a Hot Zone. It's supposed to be a hot drop. Teams want to fight over this. They want to get in there and get the good loot. But I will say, I don't think it's ever been actually worth dropping at one of these POIs. But lo and behold, Respawn has now increased our gold loot in these spots. And lastly, I want to talk about the care packages. I think this is the last change, really, the last big change that I can discuss. In Season 10, the late game care package had a 75% chance to have a gun. Now, I don't know what late game is considered, but a 75% chance to have a gun when there is two teams alive feels really bad when you don't get a gun from the care package. So what they did was they actually upped the chances to get guns this season. So in a late game scenario, those care packages will have a 100% chance to include a gun, so it's worth it. In the middle of the game, they are a 75% chance to have a gun, up from 50. In early game, you only had a 25% chance to get a gun. They've now upped that to 50. Overall, I'm super impressed with this season. I've only been playing, what, 3 days at the time of recording this video, but I really am enjoying myself. I think this map is incredible. Again, this rank split is going to be the bomb. If you don't play ranked, I totally understand. Either way, I think the season is great. I'm enjoying myself. We're only 3 days deep, but I'm looking forward to the rest of the season, and I hope you guys are too. That's all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to smash that like button, drop a sub if you're not subbed already, and comment down below what you guys think of the new season. What is your favorite part of the season? And I'll catch you guys next time. This is Big Bob signing out.